Hello friends, today I am going to evaluate the ESP32 S3 capacitive touch sensing. For this, I have an ESP32 S3 board from WaveShares manufacturer. It's a nicely designed board. Additionally, I have designed another board for a different touch sensing project. I'll be using these touchpads to evaluate how this ESP32 S3 board functions. Initially, I'll directly touch these pads and check their responsiveness. Afterward, I'll place 3mm acrylic sheet pieces on them. First, I'll put a single 3mm acrylic piece to test the touch sensor's functionality, and then I'll add another 3mm acrylic sheet on top to make it 6mm and assess its performance. Here is the sketch I'll be using for this demonstration. This sketch is compatible with ESP32 S2 and S3. The example, named Touch Button V2, is available in the Arduino examples if you have already installed ESP32. To access it, go to File, then Examples, then ESP32, and you'll find it under Touch. I've made some modifications to this example to suit my needs. Since I'm using 4 touch pads, I've defined 4 different touch variables. I'll conduct 3 different tests to evaluate the ESP32 S3 capacitive touch pin performance. Initially, I'll touch the touch pads directly on the PCB. In the second test, I'll place a 3mm acrylic sheet on the touch pad PCB and adjust the threshold to observe how capacitive touch performs. Lastly, I'll increase the acrylic sheet thickness to 6mm, change the threshold again, and evaluate the performance. I have already tested these thresholds, and they work effectively. Now, I'll begin by touching the pad on the PCB directly, so I've set the threshold to 1500. There are specific functions and pieces of code that execute when an interrupt occurs. Four interrupts are defined, one for each touch pad. In this demonstration, I'm using the ESP32 touch pins T2, T5, T6, and T7. Within the loop function, whenever a touch is detected, it displays a string in the serial monitor to indicate that the ESP32 has sensed the capacitive touch. It also shows the string when we release the touch pad for all 4 switches. As previously mentioned, we are using pads T2, T5, T6, and T7. I'll now upload this code to the ESP32 S3 board. According to my plan, I've connected this touch sensing PCB to the ESP32 S3 board. I've connected the grounds of both boards together and link the touch pad to the ESP32 S3 touch sensing pin through a 510 ohm resistor. Now, I'll upload the code. Here we go, uploading. It's working, as you can see. Now, I'll touch the touchpad directly, so I've set the threshold at 1500. You can observe it here. I'll now open the serial monitor to view the output string. After opening the serial monitor, I'll reset the board. Here you can see the string ESP32 touch interrupt test has started. Now, if I touch the first touchpad, it shows T2 touched. Upon release, it displays T2 released. Let's try again. Next, T5 touched. T5 released. Now, T6 touched. T6 released. Followed by T7 touched. T7 released. In this manner, you can observe that all touchpads are working perfectly with direct touch on the PCB. Moving on, I'll demonstrate the second condition, where we'll use a 3mm acrylic sheet on top of the touchpad PCB and observe how the touch pins of ESP32 S3 perform. Here we place a 3mm acrylic sheet over the PCB. Let's see if the touchpad senses the touch or not. In this present condition, it might not work properly, so I'll adjust the threshold. Now, I'm changing the threshold to 500, which works well for 3mm acrylic sheets. Next, I'll upload this sketch. The process is ongoing and will take a moment. Now it's done. I'll open the serial monitor. Clearing the previous output, I'll test whether the touchpad works across the 3mm acrylic sheet or not. Here, T2 is working fine. T5 is also responsive. T6 and T7 also function perfectly across the 3mm sheet. Let's test the same once again. I'll reset the ESP32 board. You can see it's working perfectly. Now, what I'll do is add another 3mm acrylic sheet over this one, making the total thickness 6mm. We'll then test if it works or not under this condition. If I try now, you can see it's not working. So, I'll adjust the threshold, and then we'll see if it works or not. Let's change the threshold and upload the sketch to ESP32 S3 once again. Here, we've adjusted the threshold for the 6mm acrylic sheet, setting it at 165. Now, once again, we'll upload the sketch. It will take a moment. Now it's done. Let's open the serial monitor, clear the previous output, and test whether the touch works across the 6mm or not. Just press the reset on the board and clear the screen once again. Let's test. I'll touch T2 and release. Now, T5, touch and release. I'll touch T6. Now, T7, touch and release. It's working perfectly even across the 6mm. Here, you can see the acrylic sheets I used in this test. These are 3mm acrylic sheets across which I performed the touch sensing performance test of this ESP32 S3 board. Don't forget to show your support by liking this video, sharing it with your friends, and subscribing to our channel for more tech insights and exciting demos. Thank you so much for tuning in, and we'll catch you in the next one.